Hi, and welcome to my The Man with the Golden Gun movie review. So, normally I would come here and tell you that I'm reviewing James Bond movie once a month. I am until November 8, 2019, but James Bond 25th is now releasing on, Demon 25th, and I released it on November 8, 2019 anymore because the previous director left because Daniel Craig wanted Demon to die at the end of Demon 25th. So he left, and now they got Kerry Coulier. Let me get his name right so I can pronounce it. Kerry Fukunaga, Fukunaga, okay? And release date, 2020, I think it, they said February 14th, 2020. So, I got the rest of this year and the rest of 2019 to review James Bond movie for y'all and talk about it, okay? And I will be in 2020. We're seeing James Bond 25th and reviewing for y'all, okay? I'm a big James Bond fan. I got my James Bond shirt on, okay? I grew up with James Bond, collecting James Bond movies on VHS. It's another James Bond movie that I got on VHS, okay? And, so, to me, this is just an okay James Bond movie. You know, it's rated PG. James Bond movie, we just rated PG all the way up to the Living Daylight with Timothy Dalton. And the reason I say that because the Living Daylight was the last James Bond movie to be rated PG. And then the next James Bond movie after that was called License to Kill. And License to Kill was the first James Bond movie ever in the history of James Bond movie to be rated PG-13. Okay? It said here 2 hours and 4 minutes, and directed by Guy Hamilton, and Dale Manga, and Christopher Lee played Dale Manga, the guy that had three nipples, and he played in the Lord of the Rings, and played Count Dooku, and Attack of the Clone, and Revenge of the Sith. When Anakin cut your head off and stuff. So, I think they could have done him, have him be a little better villain in this movie. Cause you know, in the movie, you know, they might can fight him at the end and kill him and beat him. That's obvious. And, what James Bond did to him at the end of the movie, you know, just a joke. That hit my gun against your water, PPK. I like that one thing when James Bond got rough with the woman and slap her. You know, that tells you James Bond don't mess around. You don't get in James Bond's way. But my favorite thing in the movie is the dojo thing where he'd have a crying uniform on, or taekwondo uniform, whatever you want to call it, but the dojo thing, and he bow, and then right before they fight, he kicked the guy in the face and he runs off. The funniest thing in the movie, that's right here on the VHS box. It's funny, and my favorite thing in the movie, funny. Every time I watched it, it's funny. But overall, the movie just okay, nothing special. If I did have to make my top 10 favorite James Bond movie, this would not be in it. This is just an okay Roger Moore movie. And that's one of the worst, just an okay average James Bond movie, okay? And that's why I'm going to give it a solid 3, okay? The next James Bond movie I'm going to review next month, some consider his best James Bond movie that Roger Moore played in at James Bond. And we'll talk about it next month. And thank you for watching The Man with the Golden Gun movie review. And I give it a D. And thank y'all for watching.